Hello, this is Jose Luis here at Parametric Camp, and welcome to another video in our series, Advanced Development in Grasshopper. I am recording this video from the future, where we have Rhino 8 and we have an updated version of the C# script component, because if you are watching this playlist in the future, when I was recording the original playlist, it was Rhino 7, and we were using the older version of the C# script component. So if you are using Rhino 8 or greater, you may have noticed that if you right-click on the C# script component, there is no manage assemblies or load assemblies like we used to have, okay? What happened is that when they updated the script component in Rhino 8 or higher, they change the way assemblies are loaded. So I want to record this video because you've probably seen the previous one where we loaded assemblies using the older version of the C# script component. All right. So what I've done in this video is I have recreated the same components, creating a person from a class that we have built into a DLL that we have somewhere here, like a person class of DLL, all right? And then I want to encode that into an object and then decode it into another component, all right? So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to remove everything. I'm going to plug in here what I had before, and then I'm going to remove this component, and I'm going to plug this here. And you can see that right now it's doing nothing, all right? So if you remember from the previous video, what we did here was I'm trying to use the C# script component to create an object of the type person. And that type is a type that we have created in an external DLL that we have built with Visual Studio. All right, that DLL is here. So before, in the previous video, what we used to do was to just attach that DLL by managing the assemblies in one of the options that we had here. We don't have that anymore in Rhino 8. The way to load assemblies in Rhino 8 is slightly different, and it's managed inside of the script editor using this button here, which is for installing third-party packages for this script. The moment we click this, we have two options. We have options for sourcing our package from the new Get Package Manager. I will talk about that in a second, but we're going to start by taking a look at DLL references. DLL reference is basically referencing a file that is living somewhere in your system, okay? Very similar to what we did in the previous video. So the way to specify that package is here in this text box to write a fully qualified way of finding, a fully qualified path to finding that file. All right. If that file was somewhere in my file system, I would probably type c:\my_desktop\files\whatever. But absolute paths are typically not a good thing, because if the file changes, whatever, I don't know. I don't like them a lot. I like relative paths much better. What does that mean? It means that if the Grasshopper file that I'm working with is this one, and that if the DLL lives in the same place that that Grasshopper file lives, then the relative path is just no path. It's just the name of the file. You don't have to add any relative path. What you could do is you could say, you could create a folder here and you could call it libraries, for example, and then move the person class in there. And then the relative path would be something like, wherever I am, go into the library path, and then \person\class.dll, which is the name of the file that we are trying to load. All right. Now, when I click add reference, you will notice that what the editor will do is that it will immediately add this hashtag r, and then the location of where to find that file. Remember that now, that is a way of referencing the package. We still have to load the person class into the script as a library. And once we have that, now we can say person p equals a new person, all right, with this name, this age, and whether if it's a professor or not, all right? And then I want to output that p. I'm going to execute this, and you can see that right now, perfectly, I have created this person. It's a person class, same thing as we had before. Now I'm going to do the same. Now for here, I'm going to open the script editor that I want to use to deserialize that object. And I'm going to do the exact same thing. I'm going to import the package. I'm going to go to DLL reference that is inside of the library / and is the file called person class .dll. I'm going to import it. I'm going to say using person class. And then I'm going to take the object that I created and I'm going to say person P equals, and then I'm going to cast the object like we did before, person class person. All right, I'm going to run this this, and then I'm getting an error. Person class is a, oh sorry, not person class, person, exactly. I'm going to do that, and then name is going to be equal to p.name, then, oh excuse me, then age is going to be equal to p.age, and is professor equals p.isProfessor. All right, I'm going to execute that, and you can see that none of this could be found. Maybe I am messing something up with the casing. Is that correct? Yes, because they're uppercase. All right, so let me fix that. Uppercase, upper A, and upper I. And then, boom, the thing is working. All right, fantastic. So that's great. So basically, just remember that if you want to load a static DLL from file in your system using the new version of the C# script editor, you just have to go through the import package, DLL reference, and type here the absolute or the relative path to where that file lives in your system. Now, in the next hands-on exercise you're going to do in this playlist, you're going to see in the mesh components video, you're going to see that in that video, something that we're going to do is that we're going to download a geometry library that lives somewhere in the internet. We're going to download it as a DLL file, and we're going to load it into the Grasshopper components to do advanced mesh manipulation. What's interesting is that that library that is called geometry3sharp lives in this place also called NuGet, which is basically a packet manager. It's basically a repository where people who contribute open source code can just upload these packages, and it makes downloading and versioning of these packages a bit easier. So in the next video, you're going to see that the way I do the exercise is by going to the repo of geometry3sharp, downloading the DLL, and manually uploading it and connecting it to Grasshopper. What I want to show you here is an alternative version, when instead of doing all this manual downloading, what we simply do is inside of Grasshopper, inside of the script component, we use the NuGet reference to directly download and link that assembly directly from the NuGet manager. All right, what does that look like? It looks like something like this. So I've created an empty component, all right? And if I double click, I opened my script editor. I'm going to remove everything that I have here, and I'm going to open this, all right? So what you can see now is that when I install the package, I have the option to install packages from NuGet. Remember, again, NuGet is the packet manager for that is maintained by Microsoft, I believe, for C# libraries, all right? If you were using this from the command line, the way you would write the way to import that package is using this command line instruction. However, if you look at the documentation on the Rhino developer website on how to import NuGet packages, you can see that there are certain idioms, there are like certain ways to express with the name of the package and the version that you want to download. So the way I'm going to do that is I'm going to import the install the package. I'm going to write NuGet here. And then what I want to do is I want to write the name of the package, comma, and the version that I want to target. Targeting a particular version is typically a very good thing, because then you know that that version is always going to be the same and that future updates are not going to break your code, etc., etc. So I'm going to paste this line that I copied from the NuGet manager. I'm going to remove everything that is not the name of the library. And then I'm going to replace this with a comma and with version 1.0.324. All right. The moment I hit install, you're going to see that this new line shows up. This is not anymore a reference to a file in your system. This is a reference to a package that lives on the NuGet package manager. This is the name of the package and this is the version. And now remember that you need to import the namespace of this library so that you can access it on your... I will show you how to do that in the next video, but just as a teaser, this namespace is called G3, all right? And what we're going to do is we're going to create meshes with the particular characteristics of that library. Those are going to be called dmesh3. I'm going to call mesh, and I'm going to create a new dmesh3, and with true, and you will see in the next video why is that and why am I doing that, okay? And then for the output, for empty mesh, I'm going to output that mesh over there. I'm going to hit play, everything should work, but it doesn't. Empty dmesh, all right? I'm going to save this, and you can see that the output is an object of the type dmesh3, which belongs to the G3 namespace, all right? Don't worry about this. This is what I just wanted to show you, is a way of installing NuGet packages directly into the C# script editor. This particular one, the geometry3sharp, the dmesh3 object, etc., we're going to take a look at how to do that and how to manipulate and how to use this in the next video, in the next hands-on, where we're going to do mesh manipulation with C# script components, right? So let's actually go ahead and move on to that video. Thank you very much. And if you like this video, maybe consider hitting the thumbs up, subscribing to the channel, saying hi on the comments, etc. Thanks a lot. See you in the next video. Bye.